Hi, my name is David Salmon. In this video, I'd like to show you the different tools and features of Read and Write for Google. Once you install Read and Write for Google, it will give you this drop-down tab in order to access all the tools. So each of the tools up here, this one here is your word prediction, followed by your dictionary. This is your picture dictionary, and these three here are for your text-to-speech. Here's a fact finder. In case you want to do some research, you can just highlight a certain word and it'll do some research on that word or maybe a country or something like that. Here is your speech input. This would be for your speech to text. They also have a translator where you can actually translate from English to Spanish or French, and followed by all these different highlighter tools, which I'll show you some stuff that you can do later on with that. All right, the first feature I'd like to show you is word prediction. So with word prediction, what you need to do to launch it is you go to your tab and you hit prediction, and then you're going to have this box pop up, and it's going to predict what words I might want to start my sentence with. And so the sentence I'm going to write is, "There once was a little girl who had a pumpkin patch." So I can start typing, and if I don't know which there or what it was, I can actually hold over top of it, and you don't actually hear it right now, but if I go over each word, it'll actually say the word out for me. So I'm going to click on there once. Now I'm not sure if that's an S or a C, so I'm going to have a look. Oh, and I think that's what the one there. Once was a little, there's little, and let's see, girl, there's my next word, who had... it doesn't have pumpkin, so I might have to see what if I can spell some of it. Pumpkin, and it gives me two choices. I can come up with other things, but I want patch, and I click on that. So this can help a lot of reluctant writers and also those that have difficulty getting their typing done on the computer. The next two features I like to show is the dictionary and the picture dictionary. This one here is dictionary and the picture dictionary. So if I'm doing some research maybe on Peruvian food, and I don't really understand what some of the words are, or I wanted to just find out, I can just highlight the word, and then I can click on the dictionary. It'll actually come up with what foreign means. It gives me different adjectives and a pronoun, and I can do that. Or if I didn't know what flora was, I can click on it and it'll give me a definition of what flora as well. Now with picture dictionary, it's similar to that, but of course it gives you the images of what you're looking for. So if I go to my picture dictionary, I can click on and it gives me pictures of pumpkins. Again, I can go to dictionary and tell me what a pumpkin is. In Canada, we seem to love our hockey, so I can go and find out what hockey is, or see a picture of hockey, and finally, it gives you different pictures for science. And I can close them out. The next feature for Read and Write for Google is the Fact Finder. And it's just up here. It has the globe with the magnifying glass. And what I can do is I can actually just highlight what I want to find out some more information on. And I can click on Fact Finder. And then what's going to do is going to launch Google and already put it into my Google search and give me some different results. Two of my favorite features for Read and Write for Google is text-to-speech and speech-to-text. First, I'm going to show you text-to-speech, and basically all you have to do is place your cursor here and hit the play button. It'll actually read you back what is typed out. This is really great for kids when they're finished writing maybe a sentence or even a paragraph, and they can actually hear their writing read back to them and see if they need any changes that might not sound right, so they can go back and edit their work. So for example, I can click here. I'm going to hit the play button, and I'll actually get to hear what is written.
Johnny, where's your homework? Miss Martin said sternly to the little boy while holding out her hand. My dog ate it, was his solemn response.
The other thing I like about this is it actually highlights what they're reading, and then it puts a blue mark on every word that the person reads. And it's really easy to change the settings as well. If you go over to the settings up on the top right-hand corner, you can actually change the voice. I'm going to change it to Tom. You can change the speed. Maybe that was going too slow for you. You can speed it up, or you can even slow it down. And you can also have continuous reading. So now that I've changed that, I can hit the play button again, and I'll get Tom's voice.
Johnny, where's your homework? Miss Martin said sternly to the little boy while holding out her hand.
And you can also see, too, that there it is also a little bit of a faster pace of reading as well. So the next tool for Read and Write for Google is the Speech to Text. And basically what this allows students to do is click their cursor on where they want to type, but instead of typing, they can just speak into their headset. It'll put their words into text for them. And how they do that is they go up here to the little headphone, and it says Speech Input, and they would click that, and when they're done recording what they want typed, they would hit it again, and then it will put their words here. This is really great for students if they want to tell their story on the fly and they want it typed for them, or also for students that might have already written their stories and maybe their writing booklets, and then they can just have it typed on their Google Doc for them. What I also have my students do is I actually have them just do one sentence at a time, unless they're doing their story on the fly, and then that way they can just edit that one sentence and then move on to the next sentence. So I'm going to do an example for you here. So I'm going to click on the headphones and I need to start speaking. In India, there is a cool season, a hot season, and a rainy season. So now I've hit the record button again, and now I can just go in and I can change, do my editing, give it a capital. I'll take out this hyphen, comma, and a period. And then I'll just go and record my next sentence. A tropical climate has hot temperatures, dry winters, and wet summers. And again, I hit my thing, and I can go edit it. So that's basically how you use speech to text. It's actually very accurate, as long as you tell your students not to race through what they're reading, and hopefully they'll enjoy that. All right, the next feature is the translator. And basically all this does is it translates either from English to French or English to Spanish. I have it right now set up to English to French. And it doesn't really do sentences. It'll just pick the first word in the sentence. So I would highlight it and I would hit translator, and it shows me how you would say how in French. But if I wanted to find out candy, I could go here and I would find out that it means bonbon. In order to change from different languages, I would click on Settings, and I would change down here under Speech Translation to Spanish. And now if I go to my translation, candy would be dulce. I hope that's how you pronounce it. All right, the last two features I'm going to go over is a highlighting. Now, there's two different things you can do with highlighting. I can highlight things, and I can actually highlight them all, and then I can collect the highlights, and it's going to create a different Google Doc with all those things, and also references back to this document as well. And the other thing is I can also make what's called a vocabulary list. So first what I'm going to do is I'm going to collect highlights. So for example, I have this story, Jake Goes to Bat, and I want my students to highlight only the important information which explains what steps Jake goes through when he gets ready for going to bat. So here first he grabs his favorite bat, and I'm going to give it a blue highlight. It doesn't matter which color. Then he swings it twice to loosen up. I'm going to highlight it. Steps confidently into the batter's box. Then he puts the bat down and leans it against his legs. And then he hikes up his pants and tugs on both of his gloves. Anyways, I go through all these. If you accidentally highlight something, let's say I highlight this, I can always go back and go over it, and I can use the little broom here and delete that highlight. All right, so now he takes a hold of the bat. And I'll just do one more. He taps it into the dirt three times. So let's say I went through my whole story. Now what I can do is I can actually have it create a new document showing me the list of things that I highlighted, and it takes all the other stuff out. So it could be really good for a student studying on a certain topic and he just wants to get the important facts out. And so I click on this button. It asks me which ones do I want to collect. If I had different highlighted colors, I could do choose them. And then I hit OK. And then over here you can see it says that it's creating a new document. And now I have my steps. First grabs his bat, swings it tight twice to loosen up. And then also it tells me who created it. And I can also go back to the original document. It gives me a link here. And so that's how you use the highlight tool in order to collect your highlights. All right, so the second thing you can do with highlighting, again, as I said earlier, is you can actually make a vocabulary list. So again, I said I can erase these highlights if I just go over them. I can go over the whole thing here, and I can hit the little broom button. It'll clear the highlights out. And let's say, for example, I wanted to just come up with a vocabulary list for my students. So let's say I want a baseball. I can give that a highlight. Let's go with green this time. Let's say I want to find out what loosen is. Again, I'll give that a green highlight. Let's say maybe tugs. Stairs. And let's pick one more, maybe a dugout. Maybe we see what comes up with a dugout. So once I select all my things, I can actually just, I've got my my five words written here. And then I'm going to hit this vocabulary button. And again, it's gonna create a Google document for me. You see here, it's gonna create a document. And then what's going to do is actually going to get, pull up these words. It's going to give a picture of it and also a definition, and also gives a little section for the students so they can actually put their notes. As you can see, it takes a while sometimes. So here we have baseball, a game played with two teams with a bat and a ball, and it gives me a couple symbols, and then gives me a little section where I can write some notes. Here's a dugout. Obviously, it's showing a canoe for the pitcher, but it also talks about a dugout in a baseball diamond. Here's a picture of loosen, stairs, tugs, and it shows obviously somebody tugging down on something, and it also shows a tugboat. Well, there you have it. Those are all the tools and features of Read and Write for Google. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you'll have a chance to play around with some of these features. And more importantly, I'm hoping that your students will embrace Read and Write for Google as much as my students have. I know it certainly helped them with their reading and writing. Thank you.